I think that's why it's Jean's dog. Sorry, my live stream is like suffering on battery. I'm holding a pack now, but yeah, so back to the LockOn. It's lasting well. What time is it? Does anybody know?
Yes, it is 10 past 2.
10 past 2. They've been on LockOn since around 3 this morning. So admirable work by the protectors in there. Fortunately, they stopped closing it off. I'm struggling to see the messages just because of the glare and the crack in the screen. Sorry if I don't get back to you. I'll struggle now and see if I can see anything.
I don't know. So I don't know who did that or why.
Who else is live streaming today? Anyone know?
Me.
What are you on Facebook?
I'll hunt you down.
Are you on? Yeah, no, I just meant so I can tell other like people listening.
Are you friends with T?
I'm Tina Louise UK.
No, with T Dunderdale.
I don't know. I know I meant, what do you broadcast under? Are you broadcasting?
Oh,
yeah, are you broadcasting on Facebook?
Yes.
So what's your name on Facebook?
I don't really want to divulge information.
Oh, okay, don't worry about it. I just meant for other people to follow the streams, love. Just if mine cuts out, it needs to kick in. Oh, are you not public streaming?
No.
Ah. Is there anyone who is public streaming? Just if I'm the only one, if my battery goes. Yeah, I'm on Julie's one, but it's such a short lead. Hi, Wendy. Struggling to see this. Hello, sweetheart. We have another dog. So the thing about sitting on the floor is I end up being every dog's companion. Your eyes are amazing. Look at you. Hello, you're very close. We're very close. This is... I hope I don't look like prey because I'm shorter than you. I can just about make names. Hi, Jeanette. Eileen, I'm not doing so well on reading the small print though. And I have glass on, but there's glare. Have they put a ticket on that one as well?
They're wasting admin on that because they know it's not going to get used again.
Jesus. Hey, Gabrielle, right, I'm going to go back up through these and try and read. I can't, no, because every time I look at something, another one pops up. If you're there, thank you for watching the live stream. Thanks for sharing it and for keeping an eye on these protectors. It's only when we bear witness that we keep them safe, you know? It's like a lot of people say, oh, what's the point of my going? You know, I can't really achieve anything, you know, if I'm not locked on, but you can, because your presence here makes all the difference. They can't get away with what they get away with when people are watching. Hello. The people. And these guys in orange today should feel so ashamed. And even if they weren't the ones in it, they should feel so ashamed at what they did yesterday. You didn't catch up with yesterday's live streams. They were sickening. I think it's why I lost my temper today. You know, when you spend a day away, you know, family commitment, I had to not be here yesterday. But I watched the live streams, and you're so frustrated when you're not here and all you can see is your friends and fellow protectors in pain, being harmed, and the police not protecting them. I think all that wells up inside you, and by the time you do come back to sight, all that anger's already there.
God during the Holocaust. Oh, wow, they've got a new recruit.
I don't get to read the messages a lot when I am doing live stream because cracked screen and bad light, poor eyesight. And but every night I do manage to try and catch up. I don't watch the live streams back because sometimes that's too harrowing, but I do read the comments, so thank you.
Gets into the
groove. Do you need anything? Apples, water, something? Oh, you need a pee. Well, I can't do that.
Are we allowed to swap you over for another welfare lab for a little while? So you can go and go to the loo. You know, there's like a temporary loo just down there.
Where?
Just at the other side of this cordon, there's a tall green tent with a potty.
Do you remember a song by Frank?
Yeah, you just follow the green.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Amy's inside. Okay. We're doing okay.
And you make sure that you're allowed to get back in, sweetheart.
I would. And are you staying up? Yeah, yeah, it's good sleep. I made some dinner. Fantastic.
Can't quite see through all these legs, but I'm trying. They've smashed the windows of the car and got it open. Don't forget, there is still one protector actually inside the vehicle who is locked on through the full tank, or some cavity or other there, straight down to the ones who are outside the car at the bottom there. So we'll go getting the first lot out. Wasn't too hard. This one's a bit more difficult. I think we were heavily inspired by the Bentley Effect, that movie that came out and toured recently of the Australian resistance. And during that, they had some really inventive lock-ons. It was amazing. And yeah, so I think we've got nice and creative.
What's his name?
Bales.
Bales?
Normally not have so much trouble charging the phone because I have a long lead, but I've had to borrow my sister's because I gave Michelle on the lock on the other night my charger with its long lead because she needed to charge her cigarette. So I won't see her till this evening, I think. I'll get it back then. Apparently some of these police, and I didn't know this, and I still don't know because I haven't checked the research, but it's worth doing if you can do. So see the blonde, particularly militant-looking police officer in front of me. Apparently she's not on regular police force. They come from an agency. So, you know, a bit like locum staff or whatever. So they're like an agency staff agency for police. And although she's wearing an outfit that says on the back of it today, medic, we know she was the one who pulled Barbara Head's hair and dragged her across the road, one of our protectors, an older lady, only a few weeks ago. And so she might claim to be a police officer, but on that day, then today she's a medic. And I understand they can be multi-skilled, but she's not with the Lancashire Constabulary as far as we know. So I must find out. I'll try and find out later on about that. But agency police staffing for Lancashire. I wonder if it's possible to look that up and see what that's all about. And there may all be answers in the comments, but I can't really see those at the moment because the sun's on me. Which is nice. I'm not going to complain about that. Makes a change. At least we're not in the rain. Yeah, see these ones that are wearing black t-shirt things, the without the police overlay, and they don't have, I don't know, I can't see epaulette numbers either. Like that police medic doesn't seem to have a number on him anywhere. I think he's the main one with the protester removal team. I'm glad he's moving that umbrella, which is decent of him, to try and add some shelter to those people who are so hot.
Thank you.
So if you're just joining the stream, and some of you are. This afternoon, there's been a lock-on since about 3 o'clock this morning. 6 people attached to a car, 2 inside, 2 at the front, 2 at the back. 3 have been cut off and now arrested and taken to both Preston and Blackpool police stations. We still have 3 currently locked on, 2 at the back of the car, 1 inside. The one inside is attached through the fuel tank to one of the ones outside. I think they've just got this chap off, so this is the 4th protector to now be removed. Oh, all right, sweet, I got some water, love, but thank you. Right, so he'll now be arrested and taken to either Blackpool or Preston. I don't know which one. We'll see if we can find out. Is it possible to find out where the protector's going, whether it's Blackpool or Preston?
It's down to them if you want to tell you to go to.
Well, I can't get close because there's a whopping great fence in the way. Could anybody let me know where he's going to be taken? Is it Blackpool or Preston? So his family can know. Thank you. There you go. It's quite easy, isn't it, to cooperate? Simple bloody request from one human to another. Preston, thank you. So this particular protector, if you're looking to go and give support, so arrestee support, is going to be taken to Preston Police Station. I think that's where the last two that I saw went to Blackpool, and the one before I think went to Preston as well. So we'll need arrestee support at both those police stations, please. What was really sad the other day, we were discussing about arrestee support, sorting the petrol money and things, and then we discovered, of course, now we're going to have to start thinking about things like hospital support, as we know that 3 of our protectors ended up in hospital over the last day or two because of injuries received by security or police on site. So now it's a new dimension to our protest, and after 6 months, we now have to consider hospital support to get people home and ensure their welfare is okay. It's a very tight community, protectors. We don't always see eye to eye, but we support each other through thick and thin. When people will lay themselves out like this for this many hours for us, it's an amazing act of solidarity and kindness. So it's just this lady now, this female protector there, and then there's one more in the car. I think that's another female, I'm not sure. Okay. You okay, love? You all right? Thank you. Woo! At least it's quite calm now. As I say, earlier on it was intense because they had the security guards in here and they were blacking off the area and making it so that we couldn't see what was going to happen to the protectors. And as I mentioned earlier, you know, after the violence that the orange guys, the security team, inflicted on protectors yesterday, we didn't feel that it was a safe situation, and that these people in a vulnerable position attached to a car, unable to move, would then be locked into a space. And as you can see over there, there's a blacked out area. They put another one here, and they were going to go here where I am, but we lost the plot. So, well, I lost the plot, and then I walked away, and then someone much more sensible walked in and spoke reasonably to them and explained the situation, and then they did clear the orange security staff from the area. Quality of our lock-ons is very good. You know, the protester removal team, who these people are that you can see in front of you, the two in dark blue, the lady with the blonde hair and the man just leaning against the car now, are learning which types of recipe we use to fill our tubes and our barrels, and they then try to improve the equipment as a result of it, and then we have to get a bit more cunning. And the very clever people who build our lock-on tubes and put them together have to come up with new types of materials to put in there that will prevent the equipment cutting. Because our aim, every time we do a lock-on, is of course to do exactly what this is achieving, which is to prevent work happening at the site. And there's been no work happening at the site at all today. So a job well done on our part. It's been the same for days now, they've got no work done. Is that Joe?
Thank you.
Someone's got hold of a megaphone and keep being a lot more amusing than I was on it. Oh, her face is grimacing. Is she all right? Can you get in there, Cheryl? Is she okay? She's grimacing. I'll stand for this bit.
Two.
I'm leaning on you.
Yeah, thank you. 25 to 2.